So I welcome you all to the session, Clearly Audible and Visible. So let us discuss today our FMG December 21 repeat questions, recall questions. All the questions are recall based. There might be some changes in the lines of the question or in the options as they are recall based. Now a quick briefing about Unacademy Neet PG segment. With every plus subscription, you get access to both live and recorded sessions. If you miss a live session, you can watch the recordings, which are always available. Then you can study on the device of your choice. You can have access to about 25,000 plus clinical questions. You can also take the benefit of iconic subscription. And these are the Neet PG toppers who have utilized Unacademy Neet PG segment. Then you can utilize this very welcome feature, raise a hand feature, where you can directly communicate with the teachers during the sessions to clarify any of your doubts. And these are the tests which are scheduled from time to time, targeting different exams for plus classes also, plus subscribers, as well as there are some tests which are free also. Then these are the batch courses which are starting on 15th of December. That is today. So focus FMG 2022 batch targeting your June 2022 FMG exams. Then our upcoming Neet PG 2022 batch course, a TND batch course, is also starting on 15th of December. And there is a upcoming Neet PG combat where you can grab multiple prizes based on your All India live rank. Save the dates 19th of December at 5 p.m. 60 minutes, 45 questions. From your I, ENT and PSM subjects. And you can avail multiple scholarships which are available based on your All India live rank. And this is also going on with every 2 year subscription. You get 4 months in extra with 1 year. You get 2 months with 6 months. You get 1 month in extra without any additional charges. And you can use the code VISHULIFE to get a discount at the time of checkout or to utilize any Unacademy Plus subscription or to open the Unacademy special sessions on Unacademy app. So let us begin with our questions, tentative questions, which are all recall based. There might be some errors because everything is recall based. So neglect that part. But yes, we will try to have a healthy discussion so as to reach the most probable answer of the questions which were asked. In total, about 15 questions were there from FMT subject. So the weightage of the subject is already there. Weightage has increased based on the increased number of duration of your MBBS curriculum of the subject itself. So let us start with the questions. According to MDP Act 2021, abortion is legally allowed up to. So this was a pretty simple question. The best answer goes with, all of you know the answer. The best answer goes with yes, option D. Now, as per MTP Act 2021, earlier the medical abortion was allowed only up to 20 weeks. But in 2021 Act, this was the change which was done, that normally now it will be allowed up to 24 weeks. And not only 24 weeks, suppose instead of this option, they give you at any time of gestation, that can also be a correct answer. Because as per MTP Act 2021, if there is substantial fetal abnormality, and if the case is referred to a medical board comprising of an obstetrician doctor, a pediatrician and a radiologist, and they give the opinion that because of this substantial fetal risk, the abortion can be allowed. So it can be allowed even after 24 weeks. That means at any time of gestation, based on that indication, based on the opinion of a medical board. But here the question most likely was like this. The options were like this. So best answer to mark here is up to 24 weeks. Now, as per MTP Act 2021, for up to 20 weeks of medical abortion, one doctor opinion is needed. Between 20 to 24 weeks, two doctor opinion is needed. Correct? Correct answer is option D, 24 weeks. Another question was like this. This was a simple question. Excessive sexual desire in males is known as, what do you call this? Excessive sexual desire in males. This is referred to as satyriasis. Option B is the correct answer. The same phenomena, if instead of this male gender, female word is there, then your option or answer will change to option A, nymphomaniac. So these are the important perversions which are repeatedly asked in different exams. what I can do is, what we can do is, we can divide these perversions like perversions requiring a partner for sexual gratification. How do you define perversions? Sexual gratification without actual sexual intercourse activity. So where a partner is required means the perversions like pedophilia, sexual affinity with children. Sadism is giving pain to partner and getting sexually gratified. You need a partner. Masochism is, you don't need a partner actually. Masochism is giving pain to self. Torturism is rubbing off private parts in public to a female's posterior. So all these usually require partner. So there are some perversions which don't require a partner, like voyeurism, exhibitionism. Voyeurism is a punishable offense under 354 CIPC. Exhibitionism, on the other hand, can be a punishable offense. Exhibitionism is display of private parts in public. Asked recently, NEET PG exams. Exhibitionism can be a punishable offense under 294 IPC. Then perversions requiring some inanimate object or articles as a stimulus for sexual arousal. They can be fetishism or transvestism. Transvestism is wearing clothes of opposite gender. Fetishism is objects become objects of sexual desire. And there are some perversions which exhibit excessive sexual drive, where the people show excessive sexual arousal or sexual drive. They are referred to as satyriasis in males and nymphomaniac in females. So remember these important perversions. All these are important questions. Every session they ask one question from perversions in your exams, isn't it? So these were our first two questions. Let us move on to next one. This was an interesting question. A physician doctor referred a patient to a radiologist. Some person, something like this was given in the question, as told by students, that some person known to the radiologist later visited the physician doctor with a thank you letter and a money packet. What is true regarding the above situation? This is an interesting question. The question is, there is unwanted referral by this physician doctor to a radiologist. That is why he is getting money. Otherwise, why will a radiologist give money to a physician and that to a thank you letter? What is true regarding our situation? What is this situation called as? This is the unethical act. Not to be done. Not to be done. And referred to as medical dichotomy. What is medical dichotomy? Option B is the correct answer. If the lines of the question were like this, best answer goes with option B. Medical dichotomy is fee splitting between doctors, fee splitting or fee sharing between doctors by unwanted referrals or unwanted recommendations to gain some favor in the form of money or whatever. Okay. The best answer here goes with medical dichotomy. Earlier they asked one question in FMG exams. The question was related to association. Association is not with a doctor. Association of a doctor is with unqualified people. And that is referred to as covering of unqualified people by a doctor. So association or covering cannot be your answer. This basically goes with medical dichotomy. And all these are unethical acts. For unethical acts, if the act is a punishable offense in law, then the doctor can be punished. If the act is not mentioned in the IPC sections, like this dichotomy, so now the punishment will be given by respective state medical council. So that answers our this third question. Medical dichotomy goes as the correct answer, option B. Let's move on to next question. This was a simple one, pretty simple one. I think some image was also given, but few students told that image was not given. So basically, we have covered in our classes how to identify cobras, how to identify crats, and the varieties of crats and the varieties of cobra, like common cobra, king cobra. Then we have studied about everything about vipers also. And the basic thing to remember is, yes, cobras and crats are neurotoxic. So best answer goes with option B. That is, cobra venom is neurotoxic. Then they can ask you in further exams. The venom of cobra acts over presynaptic region or postsynaptic region. Always remember, cobra venom acts over postsynaptic receptor area. Whereas common crat venom acts over presynaptic regions. That all we have covered in our classes. Then vasculotoxic snakes are snakes. Vasculotoxics are your vasculotoxics are vipers. V for vasculotoxic, V for vipers. So correct answer goes with option B, Bombay, neurotoxic. This was the simplest question, I think. a repeat question from All India PG exams. This was asked in All India 2019. A dead body was brought for autopsy. Odor in such case will be. So basically, they wanted to decipher you all that what is the image showing you. Basically, the image was related to mummification, as told by many students. And this image is also going with mummification, where the dead body gives a dry, shriveled appearance. The appearance is lean and thin, dry, shriveled. So yes, that goes with mummification. And the odor of mummification will be? Mummification occurs in those dead bodies which lie in open air condition and the climate is hot and dry. Hot and dry wind is blowing. That leads to desiccation of body tissues and body organs and gives rise to mummification. And the odor is? There is no odor. Basically, the correct answer goes with option D. They are odorless. Mummies are odorless. Whereas option A goes with ammoniacal odor is associated with adipose ear formation, where the dead body is lying in a hot and humid climate. Bitter almond goes with cyanide poisoning. Burnt rope goes with cannabis poisoning. So this was the image of your mummification. And suppose they give you adipose ear image, they will show you a sort of image like this. This dead body is showing you adipose ear formation, where the dead body will have a creamy yellowish appearance. A for adipose ear, A for ammonia like odor or ammoniacal odor. Correct? Correct answer here is option D, odorless. Odor of mummies is they are odorless. And we have revised the table of odors, and I told you before the classes also that you will get one question either from table odors, odor table, or from PMS color table. See, one question is already there. All the questions have been covered in recent special classes also, along with the plus class. A body was recovered within few minutes of death and following condition was noted. Next question. Something like this was there in the lines of the question. Exact recall cannot be done, obviously. But tentatively, these were the lines of the question. And this is most commonly associated with. They asked you something like this and they give you one option as cadaveric spasm. Best answer to mark is cadaveric spasm in such a question, where you are shown clenched fist with something in the clenched fist. And if they have mentioned that within few minutes of death, this was the condition which was noted. What is being noted is that these group of muscles, the hand muscles, they are not showing you primary relaxation. They are in a contractile state just at the time of death. So this is what is cadaveric spasm, also referred to as cataleptic rigidity, instantaneous rigidity, instantaneous rigor mortis, or postmortem spasm. So cadaveric spasm is the condition in which muscles which were in contraction at the moment of death, they, in those muscles, ATPs were lost. So they remain in a contractile state itself because there are no more ATPs to relax them. So there is no stage of primary relaxation in these group of muscles. This answer goes with cadaveric spasm. Going one step ahead, also remember, suppose they show you in another exam, in suppose June month exam, they show you that a person is holding a firearm weapon and in his clenched fist and he's tightly gripping it. That goes towards suicide or homicide. Suppose they ask you a question like this. Yes, whenever you see a weapon and which is tightly gripped by the person and that is showing you cadaveric spasm of hand muscles, that goes towards suicidal attempts. Because if a person is killed and if you try to place a weapon, the weapon won't be tightly gripped. Always remember this. Next time they can ask you a question like this. So if the weapon is tightly present between the clenched fist, like a knife, like a firearm weapon, whatever, with which a person can kill himself, that goes towards suicidal tendency. Right? But here the answer, best answer, because cadaveric spasm was itself in the option, just goes with cadaveric spasm, because presence of grass or any other thing which is not a weapon, you cannot tell whether it was suicidal attempt or homicidal attempt. That is a matter of investigation. Next question. This was another interesting question. During autopsy, the following finding is noted. This finding is clinically suggestive of. So they showed you autopsy image where the sternum was removed and you can see the thoracic organs like your lungs. Then you can see lungs over here on this side, left side, right side. and over here is your heart area. When the pericardium was removed, you saw a lot of blood in the pericardial chamber. That basically is a case of hemopericardium, presence of blood in the pericardial cavity. Clinically, this is suggestive of, yes, this is referred to as cardiac tamponade. Best answer goes with option B, that is cardiac tamponade. And you get a triad also, triad of Beck's triad, where you get muffled heart sounds, MDH, muffled heart sound, distended neck veins, H for hypotension. Cardiac tamponade is associated with Beck's triad. Now answer this one. This also was a prediction and it obviously came in your exam as an image-based question. So all the 15 questions were recently covered in special classes or in the form of YouTube sessions and obviously in plus classes. All the questions were predictable and they were easy from my subject at least. Examination of a stain sample under microscope, crystals were seen as shown in the image. These crystals are formed in which of the following test? So as I told you, the moment you see brown rhombic, brown color crystals, two tests should strike you. Teichmann's, Florenz. In the absence of Florenz, go with Teichmann's because they cannot give you Florenz because the output is same in both the tests, Teichmann's as well as Florenz. Best answer goes with Teichmann's test. Other way around, how can this question be framed? Examination of a red stain sample. So yes, then the answer has to be Teichmann's because Teichmann's is a test for red stain sample analysis, whether the sample is blood or not. But the moment they write here a white stain sample, which option they will have to add in the options? Florenz test. Florenz test, the sample is a white stain sample. Under microscope, the output is same, but the sample is different. Okay? So brown rhombic crystals are formed in microscopy in two tests, Teichmann's and Florenz, where the suspected sample is itself. The reagents will be different. Output is almost same. In Barbarios, you get yellow needle-shaped crystals, another microscopic test for white stain sample. Takayama and spectroscopy are for red stain sample. In Takayama, you get pink feathery crystals. And spectroscopy is the most reliable test for blood stain, red stain analysis, whether the sample is blood or not. Another hit question. Then I told you, well, you will get one question from agricultural poisons. And here we are with a 40-year-old patient comes to casualty with history of unknown poisoning. The attending doctor noticed excessive sweating, blood pressure of 80 by 60 means hypotension, bradycardia. All these are telling you, yes, the person is having a cholinergic syndrome-like feature. Means there is excess of acetylcholine. Why will there be excess of acetylcholine? If the person has consumed something which is inhibiting your acetylcholinesterase enzyme, the degradation of acetylcholine is not occurring, and that too the enzyme is inhibited in an irreversible competitive manner. So lots of acetylcholine giving rise to lots of muscarinic and nicotinic signs and symptoms like bradycardia, hypotension, excessive sweating, salivation, lacrimation, urination, diarrhea, you all know, GIT, distress, emesis. So the doctor has to treat with atropine and atropine to counteract the cholinergic features. You have to give an anticholinergic and best is give atropine IV, IM or IV, depending on the presentation of the patient. Okay, so this was a question related to your OPC poisoning, pesticides poisoning. So answer goes with atropine. Option one option could not be recalled. There might be some errors in recalling of the option. We are trying to reach the most tentative, whatever has been recalled till date. There might be some errors. Lucid interval is mostly associated with, again a predictable question, mostly associated with extradural hemorrhage, referred as the best answer of choice over subdural hemorrhage. The best answer to mark here goes with option A. That is, EDH means extradural or epidural hemorrhage. What is lucid interval? Person was unconscious, he regained consciousness, again becomes unconscious after some time. So that period of consciousness between two unconscious phases is associated with EDH as the best answer. SDH can also show you lucid interval phases, SDH cases. Then insanity cases. This term is associated also with insanity. In insanity, lucid interval is the phase of soundness between two insanity phases. Correct? Best answer here goes with option A, EDH, extradural hemorrhage. Again, a hit topic. In FM, all the questions were hit topics, which were predicted. A chronic alcoholic with history of 25 years of alcoholism, something like this was there in the lines of the question, told by any students, suddenly left this word, sudden alcohol withdrawal. And after about 72 hours, which of the following is seen as a withdrawal feature? Best answer to goes with is, without any second doubt, option D is the correct answer. Delirium tremens as the best answer. What is delirium tremens? At about 2 to 3 days of sudden alcohol withdrawal in a chronic alcoholic, you get features of excitability. Why? Because at neurotransmitter level, there is reversal. Now there will be too much of glutaminergic activity and depressed GABAergic activity. Excitatory neurotransmitter activity gives rise to features like agitation, seizures, clouding of consciousness, hallucinations, tremors, and the person is delirious. Condition is delirium tremens. Best answer. Option A is a complication. Pernix encephalopathy, Korsakoff psychosis, they are complications of alcoholism. They are not withdrawal features. Let us move on to next question. Again, a hit topic. 40-year-old patient present. Age can be different. Age can be different. This is just based on recalls. 40-year-old patient presents in casualty with lacrimation. Features have been recalled properly, I think. Lacrimation, diarrhea, congested eyes, tachycardia, and hypertension. Which of the following should be suspected? I will tell you a simple line to remember throughout your medical science career. Poisoning symptoms and withdrawal symptoms. What is the basic difference? Withdrawal symptoms will be opposite of poisoning symptoms. Easy? Even a layman will say that a person is having the effect of, suppose, opium. If the person leaves opium, all the effects now will be just opposite to the effects of opium. If a person is a cocaine addict, the effects now will be opposite of cocaine effect. Okay? This is in general to remember. Now let us read the question. Let us see the options, clinical features which are given. Water is coming out in the form of lacrimation, diarrhea, congested eyes, tachycardia, hypertension. All these features are not seen in opium poisoning. But tachycardia, hypertension, they can be seen in cocaine poisoning. We are talking about poisoning. Cocaine poisoning is showing you hypertension, tachycardia. So cocaine withdrawal won't show you hypertension and tachycardia. Option A is easily ruled out. Cannabis poisoning also leads to raised vitals. Which parameters? Try to recall which we have covered. Raised vitals in the form of tachycardia, tachypnea. So cannabis withdrawal also cannot be your answer, because tachycardia is a feature of cannabis and cocaine poisoning. They cannot be features of withdrawal. What is the effect of opium overall on the vitals? All the vital parameters are down. Means blood pressure is low, heart rate is low, respiratory rate is low. And if a opium addict suddenly leaves opium intake, yes, reversal of the features can occur in the form of raised heart rate, raised blood pressure, raised respiratory rate. Okay. Now my option C is fitting with the clinical features in the lines of the best answer to mark here is, yes, the person is showing you features of opium withdrawal. Lacrimation, diarrhea, rhinorrhea, yawning, congested eyes, tachycardia, hypertension. All this is highly suggestive of opium withdrawal. Opium. Dhatura poisoning cannot be your answer. In Dhatura, what happens? Dhatura is a deliriant poison. And the active principle is atropine. Okay? What is the effect of atropine, or what will be the effect of Dhatura poisoning? Dry, hot skin. All the secretions will be dried up. You won't get lacrimation and diarrhea as feature. The best answer goes with option C, opium withdrawal. This was again a question which has not been recalled properly. But yes, location of the finding has been confirmed by few students. So this told us that yes, there was a mark-like thing present over lower abdomen in the midline. So highly suggestive of a surgical incision will heal with scarring. Okay, surgical wounds are incised wounds produced by scalpel blades, and usually over lower abdomen you can get if the scar is like transverse, that will be a caesarean scar, open scar. If it is midline laparotomy, that one will be a vertical scar. Whatever may be the image, it was not tattoo mark, it was not showing you black colored image, it was not a mole. Ligature mark is usually present over neck. No one puts a ligature around waist. Okay, agreed. So best answer goes with scar if such a image was there in the question. So these were our respective questions of the exams. Let us go through them quickly, all the questions in a quick manner. According to NDP Act, abortion is legally allowed up to, in the given options, option D is the best answer. Okay. Excessive sexual desire in males, satyriasis. In females, nymphomaniac. Here the answer goes with option B, satyriasis. Unwanted referral of a patient to another doctor friend to get money is referred to as medical dichotomy. Fee splitting between doctors by unwanted referral. Toxicity of cobras is, they are neurotoxic, cobras and crats. The image shows mummification, and mummification is odorless. Option D is the correct. Because cadaveric spasm was in the options, so yes, best answer goes with cadaveric spasm itself. If you see a clenched fist, and in the classes also I have shown you a clenched fist image. Remember? The moment you see blood in the pericardial chamber, that goes with hemopericardium, clinically referred to as cardiac tamponade. Cardiac. Brown rhombic crystals under microscope is associated with Teichmann's test. Option B is the correct answer. Based on the clinical features given in the question, the case goes towards a case of pesticide or OPC poisoning, and so the treatment will constitute of your atropine and atropine as the antidote of choice. Lucid interval is mostly associated with extradural hemorrhage as the best answer. Option A. Chronic alcoholic suddenly left alcohol after 72 hours, he will present with delirium tremens. Option D. Based on lacrimation, diarrhea, congested eyes, tachycardia, hypertension, the case goes towards opium withdrawal. Findings based on location of this scar goes with, the answer is scar itself. And suppose you get a question from that same image, that cardiac tamponade image, you get a question in your upcoming June month, question like this: what clinical finding is most likely associated with the autopsy finding in the figure? The autopsy finding is suggestive of cardiac tamponade, and you get which triad? Beck's triad. Is Beck's triad made up of muffled heart sounds, D for MDH, M for muffled heart sounds, D for distended neck veins, means increased JVP, jugular venous pressure. Distended neck veins will be there. Then H for hypotension. What clinical finding is most likely associated? Yes, increased JVP. In addition, you can get hypotension, you can get tachypnea, you can get tachycardia. So answer goes with option D. Remember Beck's triad. Future prospective question. So that's all for today. Do suggest any changes in my Telegram group in the name of FMT Concepts or in Unacademy Neet PG Telegram group so that I can make necessary changes. Do suggest the changes in the Telegram group, not in the comment section in this channel, not in the YouTube channel. Suggest me in the Telegram group, my Telegram group, or in Unacademy Neet PG Telegram group. And I will make necessary changes, and then I will share the PDF with you. Thank you, everyone. Bye-bye.